Live the life principle number one, dare to dream.
Dare to dream again. Far better it is to dare mighty things, to win glorious triumphs even though checkered by failure, than to take rank with those poor spirits who neither enjoy nor suffer much because they live in the gray twilight that knows neither victory nor defeat. Teddy Roosevelt said that, and it's so true. Do you remember when you were a child and no dream seemed too big? Some of us thought we would walk on the moon. Some dreamed of riding with Roy Rogers. Others imagined stepping to the plate in a big league game. Every single one of us, when we were young, we had a common trait. We were dreamers. The world hadn't got to us yet to show us that we couldn't possibly achieve what our hearts longed for. And we were still years away from realizing that in some cases we weren't built for achieving our dream. As a matter of fact, I realized about my junior year of high school that I was too short and too slow to play professional basketball, which was my dream. You know, the dreamer's always the last to know. Eventually, we start to let our dreams die. People began to tell us that we couldn't do the things we wanted. It was impossible, they said. Responsible people don't pursue their dreams. Instead, settle down, get a job, be dependable. Take care of business, live the mundane, be content. Do you know what I say to that? I say, hooey. It's time to start dreaming again. Why? Here's just a few reasons. Number one, to avoid regret. You know, there's going to come a time in our life when we're going to be at the end of our lives and we're going to be looking back and all we will have is our memories. But those things that we didn't actually do, we will regret. The things that we wanted to do, the things that we dreamt of doing, but we didn't do, will bring regret. I want to make sure that when I get to the end of my life, and I hope that you want to make sure that when you get to the end of your life, that when you look back over the course of your life, you have no regrets. You tried everything you wanted to try. You pursued every dream that you had. The second reason is to make the world a better place. Why should we dare to dream again? Because most people who have big dreams are the kind of people who make the world a better place with their dreams. They have dreams that not only benefit them, but also benefit others. And we make the world a better place with our big dreams. The third reason is personal and family fulfillment. I want to feel fulfilled in my life. I want to feel a sense of joy and satisfaction with who I am and what I've become, but also what I'm doing. What I'm attempting, what I'm trying, what I'm dreaming of. I want to build great things for my family, not only while my kids are at home, but as my kids leave. I want to provide my family with everything that I can provide them with. The last, number four, is leaving a legacy. There's going to come a time when we are gone. And when we're gone, we will leave something behind. And that's our legacy. What will my legacy be? I want my kids, I want my friends, I want my family. I want those who know me in every kind of way to think back about what I did with my life and what kind of person I was, the bigger dreams that I dream for myself, the greater things that I attempt, the wonderful things that I achieve. Those are the kinds of things that become my legacy. And as I develop those for myself and for others, those are the kinds of things that leave a lasting legacy that people respect and admire. My challenge to you: dare to dream again, so you won't have to have any regrets, so you can make the world a better place, so you will enjoy personal and family fulfillment, and you will leave a lasting legacy. Big dreams, big rewards. If you haven't noticed, I talk a lot about dreams. That's because I believe every single person has a dream inside of them just waiting to be turned loose. Each man and woman has a desire to do something great, to achieve excellence, or to go somewhere wonderful. Now, most of the time, these dreams have been hidden and forced inside because of fear or some other circumstance. Many times, these dreams have been put on the back burner to simmer while the, quote, normal life goes on. I'm on a one-man mission to destroy the concept of keeping dreams inside and to yourself. I want to motivate as many people as possible to passionately pursue their dreams and watch them come to fulfillment. But what would you get out of dreaming big, you ask? The rewards are almost endless. But to get you started, here are a few of the top rewards you reap when you dream big. Number one, you get a renewed passion for life and work. Are you feeling tired? Do you have the doldrums for life or work? There's a good reason. It's because you aren't dreaming big enough. Number two, order will come to your life. A big dream serves as a focusing point. A focusing point will serve to bring order into your life. You'll be more channeled into the directions that you want to go. Number three, a life that ends the way you want it to. There'll come a day when you'll be reflecting back on a long life. What joy you'll have to be able to be there that day with absolutely no regrets. Your life will end the way you want it to, having pursued and achieved your big dreams. Number four, a deep sense of personal fulfillment and satisfaction. As you live life, there's one thing that hounds the dreamless, a lack of fulfillment. You see, I believe we're specifically designed to have big dreams, to pursue visions of greatness. And if we aren't doing so, we'll see a certain lack of fulfillment. But when we do pursue those dreams, watch out, because you'll see an incredible sense of self-fulfillment wash over you like a tidal wave. And number five, an ability to see others' lives change for the better. Big dreams give you the opportunity to stand back and know that you've helped others grow, achieve more, and experience the best. I want you to experience those rewards that I just mentioned, and the good news is that you can. You can see your dreams become reality, and you can see your rewards multiply. So here's a checklist to get you going. Do you have an identified dream? Most people know what their dream is. They might have to think a little bit, but they know deep down what their dream is. Have you identified it? Also, have you laid out a plan for reaching it? Once you decide what your dream is, do you have a plan for going about attaining the dream? Have you taken a first step to do so? See, anything that just resides in your mind is a thought, but anything that you actually take a step toward is an action, and only actions produce results. If you truly want to see your dream come to fulfillment, you must take an action step. Have you taken a first step to do so? What is the next step you need to do to reach your dream? Rather than thinking way down at the end and focusing in on that, focus simply in on what the next step is that you need to do to reach your dream, and then go do it. And the last question is, what are the rewards you're experiencing right now from your dreams? Think through those, enjoy those, bask in those, celebrate those, but understand the rewards that you're experiencing right now. And that's going to be powerful for you, because then you're going to be able to understand that you're going to have even greater rewards as you dream even bigger. Do you have an identified dream? Have you laid out a plan for reaching it? Have you taken a first step to do so? What is the next step you need to do to reach your dream? And what are the rewards you're experiencing right now? If you have big dreams, you will indeed have big rewards. Seven steps to achieving your dream. Vision is the spectacular that inspires us to carry out the mundane. I said that once and I wrote it down because I really liked it. Vision is the spectacular that inspires us to carry out the mundane. Most of our life is lived, as we all know, in mundane, average, day-to-day kinds of goings-on. But vision, the spectacular things, the big ideas, the big dreams, the punctuated moments in our lives when we achieve great victories, those are the kinds of things that we look forward to that carry us on and encourage us and motivate us to go on each and every day, even when we're living in the mundane. Can achievement be broken down into steps? Can we look at that vision, that spectacular, and break it down into steps so that each and every day we can work on fulfilling it? Well, it isn't always that clean and easy, but I do know that those who achieve great things, who live out spectacular visions, usually go through much of the same process with many of the items that I'm going to talk to you in a few minutes about as part of that process. So if you've been struggling with achievement, think through the following with me and internalize the thoughts that I'm going to present. Then begin to apply them, and you'll be on the road to achieving your dream. Here they are, seven steps to achieving your dream. Number one, dream it. The first thing you have to do is you have to develop a dream. You have to be able to think big. And I would encourage you to just write it down, put it in your mind, whatever you need to do to dream, to think, to brainstorm. What is it that you'd like to do with your life? Dream it. Dream big. Number two is believe it. Now, this is important. It has to be believable. It has to be something that you can say, I really, truly am capable of doing this. It might be a stretch. It might be big. I might have to go and get other resources, incorporate them in, even resources I don't have right now. But the fundamental truth here is that you have to be able to believe it. It has to be achievable. Number three, see it. And what I mean by this is you have to be able to close your eyes and actually see it happening. You have to be able to picture yourself in that situation. Now, I don't think there's anything magical. I'm not one of the people that says that you create your own reality by imagining something and then cosmic forces take over. I'm not into all that kind of a visualization type of thing. But I do believe that being able to see it grooms our minds to believe it more and to bring it to the forefront of our minds and our thoughts, which produce our actions, which produce our results. So I do see a great and tremendous value in actually picturing ourselves doing these things. It makes it more believable to us. So I would encourage you, down to great detail, picture yourself. If you're like me, I'm a public speaker, and I do a lot of speaking engagements and that type of thing. And so when I was first starting out, I would picture myself in front of a large crowd, and it just made it more believable. It made it more relaxed when I finally was doing it. I was able to see it. Whatever your dream might be, maybe your dream is to build homes for a living, to start a construction company. Can you see yourself walking around that construction site, seeing big homes going up, seeing people working for you, smelling the dirt and the wood and hearing the sound of the construction going on? Those are the kinds of things that I'm talking about. See it in your mind. Number four is to tell it. That is, to get it out in the open, to create some accountability with people around you by telling them what your dream is. You know, it's really, truly amazing. When you start to tell your dream, other people buy into it. They may not help you out on it. They may not anything other than encouraging you. They come along and say, hey, how are you doing with that? And it holds you accountable to a certain degree, but it also says to you, wow, these people care about that. They think that it's great and it's encouraging and it pushes you on. So tell it to other people. The other thing that does is you'll bump into somebody, you'll tell them that dream and they'll say, hey, I can help you out on that. I can provide resources or I can provide insights or wisdom or experience or whatever. You never know who you're telling and what they're going to be able to do for you if indeed you make a connection there. Number five is to plan it. You have to have a plan. It's not just enough to have a big dream and then just kind of go willy-nilly flying by the seat of your pants. You've got to plan your dream. Set out the whole big picture and then start working back from the end and going back further and further, creating sub-points and plans for actually achieving the dream. If your dream is to lose 100 pounds, let's say that's your big dream. Well, okay, how are you going to do that? What's your food plan going to look like? What's your exercise plan going to look like? What's your goal structure going to be in terms of losing certain amounts of weight at certain moments in time? Maybe your plan is to raise money to start a business. Same kind of thing. How much money? In what period of time? How much do you need in this particular part? What kinds of people are you going to have to meet? How soon are you going to have your business plan done? Those kinds of things. You've got to have a plan written down to do. Number six follows that, and that is work it. Work your plan. You've heard the old saying, if you fail to plan, you plan to fail. Well, the same is true with work. If you don't work on it, if you don't actually execute the plan, you are planning to fail. And a plan that sits in a three-ring binder in the top drawer and never comes out and is never executed will never get you anywhere. You've got to work the plan. So the power comes in having a great plan, but then the real power comes in actually working the plan. And then the last one, number seven, is enjoy it. You know, work and dreams and all these things that we strive to achieve are really for our enjoyment. They're for our enjoyment. They are for the people who we help, for their enjoyment. They're for our family's enjoyment. And we need to take moments in time in which we celebrate and we enjoy our lives and we enjoy the things that we're participating in, to really sit back and understand that life is short and it is to be enjoyed. It is to have fun. It is to build lasting relationships. And so I would encourage you to enjoy it. So here they are again, the seven steps to achieving your dream. Number one, dream it. Number two, believe it. Number three, see it. Number four, tell it. Number five, plan it. Number six, work it. And number seven, enjoy it. And you know what? I'm going to add a number eight. And number eight is, now go back to number one. Dream it and start all over again. And this time, dream a little bigger.